Hello, my name is Babu Alagarsamy, Engineering Manager for Microsoft Bookings. In today's session, I am excited to walk you through the technical details on deploying and administering Microsoft Bookings. In this session, I will be giving an introduction to Bookings, its internals, some of the common deployment scenarios and configurations, and troubleshooting tips that will help you in managing Microsoft Bookings in a day-to-day business. What is Bookings? Bookings is a Microsoft 365 application that lets you manage the appointment scheduling scenarios both inside and outside of your organization. It allows you to manage appointment bookings with simple configurations. Think of Bookings Calendar as a container for holding the types of services offered. Each service may have a set of service providers along with their availability details. End customers will be presented with services and their availability on a given date, and they can create and manage their appointments in a self-serve mode. Bookings gives you the best experience wherever you prefer to log in from. Bookings is available as a standalone web app within Microsoft 365 and also as an app in Teams. It is also available on iOS and Android devices. Bookings API in Microsoft Graph provides programmatic access to our capabilities. The Graph APIs are currently in beta. Let's look into some of the internal components of Bookings and how its flows are controlled. Bookings uses a shared mailbox in Exchange Online to store its configuration and data. I will walk through various components that makes up Bookings, and most of them are well known in Exchange Online world. At the core of Bookings is a shared mailbox, and each shared mailbox is used to represent a set of logically related or grouped services. For example, you could have a requirement for service offered by the IT and finance department. Since they will be typically managed and serviced by two separate groups, you would create two Bookings mailboxes, one for IT and another one for finance. In general, Bookings mailboxes are managed by PowerShell admin commandlets. EWS contains methods required by the Bookings Graph APIs, and the web app uses an internal version of the API to manage Bookings mailboxes. REST mobile endpoint is used by Bookings iOS and Android apps. All of Bookings data resides in Exchange Online data store, and the data residency for Bookings is same as that of the Exchange mailbox data residency. In general, any control or limitation that you get with Exchange Online is applicable for Bookings as well. Bookings data is stored as items in the Bookings mailbox. Few of the core Bookings items map internally to a shared mailbox Exchange item. Business info in Bookings mailbox is mapped to a shared mailbox's configuration item. Customer information in Bookings is stored as part of contact in a shared mailbox. Appointments in Bookings are stored as part of calendar items in Bookings mailbox. Service and service provider are some of the custom entities specific to Bookings. Service is used to store the metadata of the offered service, and service provider holds the metadata about a user and the tenant who is assigned to provide a service. Bookings adheres to many of the known international and regional standards and terms related to privacy, compliance, and security requirements. It is classified as Category C application among the Office 365 apps, which has the industry-leading compliance requirements. Bookings is a HIPAA business associate and FERPA compliant application. It also has contractual commitments on data residency requirements to meet US and EU standards. Bookings is certified for information security and auditing requirements to protect sensitive data. Bookings does not voluntarily disclose any customer data to any of the law enforcement agencies. Let's look into some of the top deployment scenarios in Bookings. Bookings provides you multiple levels of controls to restrict access to the application. Bookings can be enabled or disabled at tenant level by visiting the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Go to Microsoft 365 Admin Center and under Settings, you can open Auth Settings and select Bookings. Under Bookings, you will have an option to enable or disable bookings for the entire organization. Along with this toggle, you will also get an option to enable or disable a couple of more controls like blocking social sharing options or staff requiring an approval explicitly to manage schedules. Some of the organizations may want to have multiple bookings calendar administrators to easily manage schedules at scale. However, they want to ensure only trained users can create new calendars to align with business processes. You can use the policies to help with this. Bookings creates a shared mailbox for each business calendar, and you can control who can create these bookings mailboxes using OAuth mailbox policies. You can create a new OAuth mailbox policy for users who should be allowed to create bookings mailboxes. This is achieved by using the new OAuth mailbox policy command. Since bookings mailbox creation is allowed by default, the new mailbox policy that you create with the new OAuth mailbox policy will not require further customization in general. You can assign this policy to relevant users who should be given permissions to create bookings calendars. To disable bookings mailbox creation for rest of the users in your organization, run set OAuth mailbox policy command along with bookings mailbox creation enabled flag set to false. This will ensure that only limited number of people within your organization can create a new bookings mailbox. For more details on how to use these commands, refer to our support pages. For scale scenarios and for scenarios where there are only limited users having permissions to create bookings mailboxes, you can create the mailboxes using PowerShell commands. Run new scheduling mailbox command with relevant parameters like the display name of the service, what should be the primary address, and who should be the owner of the mailbox, and what should be the time zone of the mailbox. This will help you create a mailbox programmatically with default settings. Post creating the mailbox, you can hand it over to the bookings admins to configure it from bookings.office.com. The bookings admins here is the user assigned as a owner in the new scheduling mailbox command or a staff that you add from bookings.office.com. When the bookings mailbox is no longer needed, you can delete it like any other Exchange mailbox using PowerShell commands or by visiting the Admin Center portal. Bookings mailbox picks up the default tenant domain from AAD for all the new mailboxes. If you have a need to differentiate Bookings mailbox domain from your regular domain address, you can visit AAD portal and configure the default domain to a custom domain, and any new Bookings mailbox created post this will have this custom domain. The domain name shows as part of the Bookings mailbox email ID, and your customers will see it when they receive communication from Bookings. If you do not want to change the default domain at AAD, you can update the domain for Bookings mailbox post creating it by visiting the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. In Admin Center, go to Users List, under which you can find the active users list. Select the account corresponding to the Bookings mailbox and go to Manage Username section. This will list down the custom domains that you had registered with AAD and pick the one that you want to assign to the bookings mailbox. When you change the domain for an existing bookings mailbox, the self-serve booking URL will also be changed to reflect this. So make sure if you had already shared a self-serve URL with your customers, post changing the custom domain, you share the updated self-serve URL to your customers. Bookings also has a public-facing API, which is currently in beta. These are exposed as part of Microsoft Graph APIs and lets you manage the bookings mailbox programmatically. Bookings Graph APIs can be used like any other Microsoft Graph APIs using the user access tokens. These APIs support the basic CRUD operations for all the bookings entities like calendar, services, service providers, appointment, and customers. Using these Graph APIs, you can build a custom application of bookings that suits your needs. The support for self-serve booking scenarios are not yet available on these Graph APIs. For more details on how to use Bookings Graph APIs, you can visit Microsoft Graph support documentation. Let's look at some of the troubleshooting tips that will help in resolving the common issues that you may encounter with or configuring bookings. If you have issues with appointment confirmation email delivery, there could be few reasons for it. Exchange spam filter could be blocking the emails originating from bookings mailbox if it is generating many emails in a short duration. In such cases, you may want to spread the load by creating bookings mailboxes for each scenario or for a category of services. If you use a non-standard name for your bookings mailbox, for example, using a GUID as a bookings mailbox name, then the spam filter could block the emails originating from these mailboxes. Choosing a standard looking name for your bookings mailbox could avoid this issue. Your tenant admin may also have policies applied that could impact email sending within or outside tenant. Check with your tenant admin to make sure they are not blocking emails originating from a shared mailbox. The email ID configured under Business Information section generally receives a NDR with exact reason for the delivery failure. Inspecting this delivery failure information generally helps you fix this issue quickly. If you have any issues around staff or service provider availability not showing up correctly, ensure that you have events on office calendar affect availability option enabled at staff details page. The availability could be impacted or adjusted if the business time zone and the staff time zone are not in sync as well. Thank you for listening in. I hope this session offered valuable information that detailed the behind the scenes architecture of bookings and gave you additional tips on how to manage bookings for your organization. Thanks for attending and be sure to visit our support documentation for further information. We also have a lot of other good talks that have been recorded for you. Here are the ones that are related to this one. Please do check them out. Thank you.